Hi, I'm Murray from Sesame Street, and I'm looking for the word on the street. What's the word on the street?
Thanks, Murray. The word on the street today is vertex. I got a lot of comments, I can't even count how many, that want me to review a vertex backpack. So the word for the day is vertex.
That's the word on the street.
So I finally got the Vertex Gadget 2.0. I know, it's been a couple of years, it's been out. People have used this bag and they can't stop talking about it. So I wanted to take a look at this bag. So this is a 25 liter bag and I think it's got a lot of functionality inside of it. It's a concealed carry bag and it's really built around that concealed carry element for this backpack. So we'll take a look at that, but if this bag can also be an awesome everyday carry bag. I kind of held off talking about this bag because it's been reviewed and reviewed, and I was like, what else can I add to the conversation about this bag? It's already been proven by so many people to be excellent, but I do have some critiques about the bag that I want to add to the conversation. So let's go to the bottom of this bag. Let's talk about it. We'll do it from the bottom to the top like we usually do. Let's go over the specs on the bag first though. This bag measures 20.5 inches tall. It's 11.5 inches wide and it can expand out to 7.5 in depth. Now this bag itself is made out of a lot of different kinds of nylon. Everything on this bag feels very high quality. YKK zips, you know, support in the right pockets or support in the right positions amongst this bag. So when you really look at this bag, it's something that this is a 2.0 version, right? So it's been refined and kind of corrected, but they still have some little issues that I find with the bag. So let's go to the bottom, let's talk about it. So on the bottom of the bag, you already have some, you know, some great quality nylon on the bottom of this bag. So it's really nothing to talk about there. As we move up, we do have a little Velcro panel or morale patch panel where you can attach morale patches. You know, I'm not the big morale patch guy, like I've said in other videos, but for those who are, you got a place to display whatever you like. Then we move up the bag, we just have this, you know, gusseted pocket in the front. And what this actually is, it's a quick access to your quick access items. You pull this tab and then you can rip this thing down and you get access to a whole bunch of Molly, some Velcro panels right here in the front. And it's really quick. You could put a, you know, a CCW right here in the front of this bag. So it could be just that quick for you to get access to it and go to work if you need to. And this little front panel also acts as like a beaver tail. So let me show you that. You have these, you know, metal G-hooks right here. So you hook these metal G-hooks to the side of the bag back here. Hook it and hook it. And now you got a little beaver tail where you could add in maybe a helmet or a jacket, any type. It gives you a lot of expandability and I appreciate that. Great little feature that Vertex is actually built into the bag using high quality materials. Love seeing metal on backpacks. One other thing that you can do with this pocket is you could fold it up and put it in the interior of the bag. There's a little pocket right here. You fold this up and then you can stick it inside. See how my arm is going all the way inside of this pocket? And then you can just have your Molly exposed or your hook and loop exposed to the front so that you can just attach your pouches and everything right to the front of the bag. Now, you can see I'm not using this right now because, you know, this bag already has a lot of organization or enough organization for me inside of it. So I don't need to attach any extra pouches to the outside. But for those who are carrying more, this is a great option. Right above this quick access pull tab, you do have a grab handle. And at first I didn't really know what this was, but in use, this is actually a great option. Get a lot of purchase over the bag, like ripping out of a car vehicle or you picking up from a car vehicle. You do have, you know, a great little grab handle here, and it's made out of like, feels like a hypalon material right here. So it's gonna wear well, and it does allow a lot of purchase, even though it's like built into the fabric. This is kind of like the first time I've seen this on a bag, and it actually works out really well. So let's move around to the side of this bag. Very interesting design on the side of this bag. And it's kind of why I've stayed away from this bag. I actually had the Gamut 1.0 version, and I didn't like the organization on the side. So let's talk about it. All right, so you do have a water bottle pockets. Now, without putting anything in these little fly compartments, which kind of like wing compartments on the side, without putting anything in those, putting a water bottle in there, especially like a larger 32 ounce Nalgene bottle, is kind of tight. Now the 27 ounce Camelback chute that I have right here fits in there with no problem. The problem comes in is when you start to stick items in these pockets right here. They got a zipper pocket right here with great mesh. It's a great design. You can see there's a lighter material in the inside of the bag that goes through the inside main compartment as well. But there's a pocket here and then a little zipper pocket here. So when you start to put items in these pockets, it becomes harder and harder to put your water bottle in or anything else in these outside pockets. It even becomes a little bit difficult for me to zip this pocket up. Like if you put a larger item inside of this zipper pocket and then a large item inside of this pocket right here, since there's no real dimension built into the side for these pockets, it just doesn't work well for me. And that's really one of the reasons why I've stayed away from this bag for so long, is because I didn't like the way this was designed. So let's go to the side and check out the other side too, because it's basically the same setup. And that's like one of your main organizational panels is on the side of these bags. And that's something that I use actually a whole lot. So I'll unzip and you can kind of see. Now this, on this side, the other side had just one slip pocket. This side has like some pinhole slots, a place where like I would think like your cell phone, and a lot of different little slots. And then it also has this zipper pocket right here. And then on the outside, the water bottle pocket where I just stuck in my little totes and umbrella. But same thing goes on this side as well. When you start to add a lot of items inside of these pockets, the pocket just doesn't close, you know, it just becomes very difficult to close, and then it also becomes very difficult to stick an item inside of there. Let's flip this bag around and talk about the back panel, which for the most part, I really, really like. The shoulder straps in this yoke system right here is excellent. The feeling on these shoulder straps is just like the perfect feel. Right amount of padding, right amount of density, and they just feel comfortable. They hug your shoulders up really well. I can't really ask for a better shoulder strap in a bag. One thing I just jumped over really quick is the grab handle. Now the grab handle does seem kind of last minute. It doesn't feel like it goes along with this bag. I would have figured that they would have done a really well padded grab handle on the top, but they actually just came with maybe that's an inch wide piece of nylon webbing, and there's some stitching inside of the nylon webbing that you can like throw a carabiner clip in to hang the bag up. It's kind of hard for me to stick my finger in right now, but trust me, it's two levels of nylon webbing. So the grab is just okay. It's not the greatest. I would have liked to seen them improve the grab on this bag with the grab handle. So moving down, you do have a sternum strap on this bag, which is removable. And you know, this is a 25 liter pack. And for me, I necessarily don't need a sternum strap on a 25 liter pack. It's really fine. I'll probably end up taking it off if I, you know, continue using this pack. You do have a hip belt, kind of same story with the hip belt. On a 25 liter pack, I can kind of, you know, use it or not use it. Really, I probably won't use it. It is removable, so that's exactly what I'll probably do, is remove this hip belt. Don't need it. It's more of a stabilization than anything else. If you're looking for these hip belts, like these one inch pieces of webbing to do any type of load bearing, they're not going to do that. They're actually just there for like if you're riding a bike, you know, the bag is moving around on your back, it's kind of stabilizes that for you. So let's take a look at the back panel on this bag. So fully shoulder straps back. Now when you take a look at the back panel, I'm impressed by the design. Now the functionality is another question. Just the pressing of the Vertex logo in the back of this bag looks good, but it doesn't give a lot of airflow between the back of the backpack and your back. So that's another complaint that I do have about this bag. I wish that this back panel had some mesh, some foam over some mesh would have been definitely better than this. Like, it feels like more of a neoprene material. Now it's very comfortable as far as, you know, putting it on your back, but in the summer I found these back panels with the neoprene to be a little hot. Now you do have a luggage pass through, so you can slide your luggage, you know, onto your carry-on bag and then slide your handles through. So that's very helpful. So if we take a look right here at the top, we have a zipper that goes all the way around the exterior of the back panel, and that's for your CCW. Now these zippers up here are all YKK like I mentioned before, but these ones in the back are lockable. A great feature, knowing that you might put your concealed carry in this bag, you can lock it up with a little, you know, TSA, one of those little TSA locks. Definitely like that feature. So you got one regular zipper, and then you have a larger pull handle so you can quickly access this back panel and get to your CCW. Now in the back panel, you can see I don't have a CCW in here. So this is like some just hook, I guess this would be the hook side or the loop side. No, this is the loop side of Velcro, so you can attach their Tactigami holsters for your mags and for your pistol. So moving around to the front of the bag again, Vertex includes a quick access pocket up here at the top, which is a pretty good size. You know, I actually like the size of this quick access pocket, bigger than a lot of backpacks that I review. So in here, I just stuck in my Maxpedition Slim wallet that I keep all my IDs in. And it also has a key keeper if I could find it in here. It's a little red key keeper. I wish this was a little bit longer so that you could actually access a lock with it still on, you know, clicked in, because the way it is now is kind of short. You really don't have too many options. You gotta unclip it, your keys, to actually unlock a lock. But like I said, very large, quick access pocket. Can put my whole hand and wrist almost in there. So, you know, keys, wallet, phone, all of that can fit in that pocket. So let's get into the main section of this bag, where big number 10 YKK zips, and I didn't mention it before, I like the lanyards that Vertex is including on their zippers. It makes it very easy to grab and just pull those zippers around. Now on the side of this bag right here, you get to a point where you can kind of, the zipper kind of stops. So that's where there's a little button here. So it kind of stops it, and what that actually allows you to do is just to fold this little lid down. And so you have some organization that you can kind of get to really quickly. So right here, I just have, you know, a Sharpie, Jutsu Pilot pen. This is a little flashlight that I picked up. Dope little flashlight, man. We'll talk about that in another video, but that's the Lumitop AA tool, I believe they call it. And then the knife that I'm carrying now is the K-Bar Dozier, which is a super light knife. I was going back and forth, like, do I wanna spend that 110 on the Benchmade Bug Out? And I was like, nah, but I found a great budget alternative right here, and that K-Bar Dozier is a full-size knife, and it's still got the same weight as the Benchmade Bug Out, just a lesser steel. But, you know, for me, I just use beater knives, you know, cut up boxes, you know, do little EDC tasks with them. I don't need, you know, a $200 or $100 knife in my pocket that I'm gonna probably end up dropping on the ground somewhere and won't be able to find. So one thing that you may notice is this little pull tab. And see, this little pull tab wasn't on my Gamut 1.0. So this little pull tab, what it actually does is you leave it on the outside of the bag so you can quickly rip open the front section of the bag, so you get the full access with the full clamshell. I love this clamshell opening. The design in this bag is great. It's a great design bag. And I even think that they've changed the weight of this bag from the Gamut 1.0 to the 2.0, because the bag itself for me feels a little bit lighter. Let's talk about the front pocket on this bag right now. So you got two little zipper pocket, and they're almost like see-through pockets, so you can kind of see your items that you stick in there. I don't have anything in these front little zipper pockets right now, but you know, throughout time I probably will find some things to throw in there. But I love this organization at the top. The fact that you can kind of just roll this over and then get to this organization. And I thought it was gonna fall out when I first started using this, but everything that I stuck in there stays in there really, really well. So let's flip around. You can kind of see what I have in this. Got my, of course, I got my Peak Designs organizer. Gotta have that. That's a tech organizer. And I got the XM3s. These are the Sony noise canceling headphones, the XM3s. These are some great headphones, guys. Best on the market right now by pretty much everybody on damn YouTube. So I had to pick up a pair, and they have lived up to everything that I expected them to be. Got an app with them, they're so damn great. Then these are my sunglasses. And then inside here, you have, you know, just a lot of space. You could pack this thing out for a week's worth of, you know, for a trip, put whatever you want in here. But clothes, definitely you can get full access to. I like it a lot. So in this back panel though, you actually have, this is where your laptop goes. So the laptop, I'm actually using my laptop right now, but the laptop itself goes in this compartment. It's a little big. That's the only thing about this laptop compartment. I wish I had my laptop in here so I could show you guys, but you can kind of see how much space is in this laptop compartment. And there's no, you know, connection at the, what am I trying to say? There's no connection up here at the top to hold the laptop back. So it just kind of moves around in there, especially if this bag is not packed out. So if I just have like my EDC items in here and then just the laptop kind of shifts around like forwards and backwards, and you can feel it in your back. So that's one thing. The tab up here is actually for a water bladder. So that's with the Vertex little tab at the top. So you can hook your water bladder in and stick it in here. And then you have holes on the side of the bag where you can run your water bladder out. Hopefully you can see my finger kind of poking through. So it just kind of runs out and then runs down the shoulder straps. It has some loops along the shoulder strap line. So if you're running a water bladder, you can definitely do that. I mean, this is a top quality bag, guys. The things that I'm pointing out are really for me specifically, but I think that this bag has been proven by so many people to be effective. It's kind of like, you know, I'm Monday morning quarterbacking out here saying, this is the problem I see with it. This is a great bag. I mean, I just see a couple of things. It's the organizational size for me, that I just can't, I need my organizational panel. The laptop, you know, compartment being too big. It's just like the major thing is the, you know, the back panel in the summertime. So for me, it's like once these little things start to add up, if I was doing like a little scale, then it's like, do I really want to carry this bag? Or is there something out there that's a little bit better? So for me, this bag is not a pass. It's just like, this is a great bag, but it just doesn't suit me. So I searched on Vertex's website. They got this bag listed right now at $214. I think that's a fair price for this bag. Definitely a good pickup. And Vertex has a lot of different colors on their website that you could pick this bag up for. So, but on Amazon, they actually have this bag at for as low as $155. I picked this up from Amazon, so I got it for like $160, so I think that's an even better price. I would pay both for this bag. It's great, it's a great bag. I think for those who are definitely running CCW, they need those lockable zippers, they wanna carry extra mags, they want the access in the front where they can put in some extra Molly pouches. The organization is decent. Really, for me, the really only only organization that I'm using in this bag is this front top pocket where it kind of rolls down, and the quick access pocket. The side bottle or the side compartments for me are kind of like obsolete. I can't really use them because I do like to run a water bottle. So for me, this bag is not the perfect bag. You know, I'm kind of on the search for the perfect bag. This is just not it. I think if I was running a CCW, I would probably feel more like this bag is the one. But since I'm not, and I have like a lot of different options for like a more civilian type of backpack, this one is like, it's good, but I got some little, you know, problems with it. But that's just me. And I don't want to cloud you guys' judgment about this bag. It's great. Everybody left me comments. I know this bag is great. Thanks for watching George the Find, guys. Please like, comment, and subscribe. I appreciate everybody that's been subscribing and commenting. And we got a, like a little conversation going on down in the comments. Man, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace. Thanks, Murray. The word on the street is Vertex. I got a number of requests in my comments. The word on the street is Vertex. I got a number of comments that want me to review a Vertex backpack. So the word for the day is Vertex.